How are you, my viewers? Once again, I welcome you to the today's word that the Lord has placed in my heart that we can share with you, because the word of God, the Bible says in John 6 and verse 68, that the word of God is spirit and it's life. What we need right now is life. And that is the message that we are going to share together with. My names are Reverend Kiboni Mwangi. I'm born again, and Christ is my personal Savior. Welcome to the book of Matthew, chapter number 16, and verse 13 through to 17. And the Bible says, when Jesus came into coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, who do men say that the Son of Man I am? 14, and they say, some say thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. 15, he said unto them, but whom say ye I am? Verse 16, and Simon Peter answered and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. 17, and Jesus answered and said unto him, blessed thou art Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood have not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is yet in heaven. Let's pray. Thank you, Father God, for your word, and thank you for your Holy Spirit. Jehovah Father, may you interpret this word so that it can benefit our spirits at a time like this. It is in Jesus' name we pray and offer our thanks. Amen. Today I want to speak about a blessed man. A blessed man. That is the topic today, and it comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 13 through to 17. And Matthew is the author of this gospel. And the purpose of Matthew writing this gospel is to portray Jesus as king. And that's why he talks about so much about the kingdom. In fact, the word kingdom is repeated almost 32 times in the gospel of Matthew. And he quotes a very wonderful text where Jesus converses with his disciples. Remember, these are men of faith who have left their professions, and they have followed Jesus for 3.5 years. And this is almost the ending of the ministry. And Jesus poses a very good question unto them. Remember that Jesus was a teacher. And one of the skills that teachers use, even me included, is the asking of questions. Maybe you can enter into a class and ask students, what did we learn last time? What is so and so? Maybe you ask a question, what does this one mean? Questions, when they are asked by a teacher, it is not that the teacher is inquiring for information from the students, but it is the teacher who wants to help the student. So in this sense, Jesus is the teacher, the disciples are the learners. So this question, Jesus is not asking for an opinion poll. He's not asking to maybe to rate how people know him, or just like the opinion polls that we have around. No, this is a question that is meant to help the disciples. And therefore, when he asks this question, he gets varying answers. And that is where now we are going to, that is where our sermon is based on. Because Jesus knew that you can live with a person and you do not know him. These disciples have stayed with Jesus for 3.5 years. They are almost now ending. Jesus is almost ending his ministry. And he looks at them and he sees, these guys do not really know who I am. And therefore, Jesus gets two versions of the answers. And this is what I want to say, that there are two sources of revelations, because these are the revelations, the answer, the questions, according to revelation. Number one, the answer number one is which they answer collectively. So Jesus asked, whom do men say Or whom do people say I am? And they are very quick to answer. They are quick to say answer Jeremiah, Elias, John the Baptist, and whatever. It is very easy to have a revelation based on what people say. And that is the first thing I would like to ask to understand. That the disciples are very quick to answer what other people say. And who are these other people? Remember, the disciples were Hebrews by birth, and they lived among us, the Hebrews. And therefore, there is what the revelations that the Hebrew people had regarding Jesus. When you read in some other gospels, they'll tell you that when Jesus was entering Jerusalem, riding on an ass, the women took off their clothing, they laid down and singing Hosanna, Hosanna. Not because they knew exactly who Jesus was, but because they were looking for an earthly king. And therefore, Jesus knows a revelation based on what people are saying around. They're saying that Jesus is an earthly king. And in fact, those answers correspond to that because they say he's Jeremiah, he's Elias, he's John the Baptist, he's just another prophet. All these four answers, remember, they refer to men, mortal men with the flesh and blood. So the Hebrews were seeing Jesus just like an other man. They could not see the God in him. They could not see the King in him. Brethren, this is also a scenario that can be replayed in us. Right now, we are in a very critical stage. Whereby we are not congregating, we are not meeting as a fellowship. And therefore, you might be having a faith based on your denomination, based on what you people say, what our preachers say, what the internet say, what the other people, your friends say. But brethren, remember that a revelation based on the understanding of men cannot help you. Man, by his own understanding, is limited in understanding the things of the Spirit. And that's why when they saw Jesus, they saw an ordinary man. Maybe you can just be in a denomination whereby you sing to Jesus and you see as if you are just singing to how we sing to the leaders of the world. Maybe when you say that Jesus is a physician, you just see a doctor in your village. You just equate Jesus with that doctor. But now, Jesus comes to another level and asks them, that is what people say, but what do you say as a person? Brethren, the second source of a revelation is what Peter answers. And Peter says, you are the Christ. And Jesus tells him, you have not known this by blood and flesh, but by our Father who is in heaven. So the second source of revelation is God himself. And it is upon this answer that Jesus comments, and Jesus seems to be happy because of what Peter answers. And we are going to check on some few things regarding that answer that Peter gives. Number one, it's not from flesh and blood. A true revelation does not come from what you know, from what you think. It comes from what God says. And that's why we have the Bible. Because the Bible says who Jesus is. And at a time like this, our faith, our revelation of who Jesus is will be tested. Because maybe I get boldness because we are so many. But right now, we are living as an individual. The government has said social distancing. Be an individual. Now, where you are at home, where you are listening to me from, who do you say Jesus is? Is he your provider? Then he is a provider. Right now, when you are not working, let him be Jehovah Jireh. Is he the healer? Right now, when the hospitals are not operating and they are just attending to the COVID-19 patients, is he your healer? is Jesus. You are the Lord and the King. Is he the one who is reigning right now? Or is it the information that you are hearing from the news, from the news channels, saying the statistics of those people who have died and those who are infected? Are these the news that are reigning in your heart? If Jesus is Lord and King, the Word of God should reign in our hearts. So this information does not come from flesh and blood. Number two, it is personal. The first answer they had given as a group, this answer is personal. Faith is not a corporate thing. Faith is personally revealed. You know God as an individual. You cannot know God as a family. There is no God that will come, the Lord of our family, the God of our community, the God of our nation. No! God is personally revealed in our lives. And it is that personal revelation that will keep you in times of distress. Daniel knew God personally. And when he was in the fire, he was not together with the rest. And because of that personal revelation, that's why Jesus came and became the fourth man in that place. Number three, it is a blessing. It is a blessing. Jesus said, blessed are you. And that's where I have gotten the title of this message, about a blessed man. A blessed man is a person who knows who really God is. We are living in an era or in an age that I normally call materialistic age. People who think that blessings are cars, big bungalows, big trunks of chambers and whatever. No. Jesus called Peter blessed man because of the revelation of he had regarding Christ himself. Are you a blessed person today? You might not be counting a lot of money in your wallet, but your heart is very rich with the knowledge of God. Let me tell you, if you know Jesus, you know that silver and gold belong unto him. You are rich. If you know Jesus, you know that he's the creator of the heavens and the world. You are rich. If you know Jesus, if you know really who Jesus is, you know that he's the great physician. So in the name of doctors, you have no access to the best doctors. You are healed. That's why the Bible says, let the poor say that they are rich. Why? Because those poor in the spirit have made it their responsibility to seek the things of the kingdom. And when they seek, the Bible says, blessed are the poor, for the poor in the spirit, for theirs is the kingdom. And therefore, brethren, are you a blessed man? Yes, if you know who Jesus is. And number four, it carries with it power. That revelation carries with it power. Why? Upon answering that question, Jesus said, and upon this revelation of faith, I will build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail. Let me tell you, brethren, if we know the power that is in Jesus Christ, if that revelation is revealed in our hearts, then that is the faith upon which God is building upon. You know, people get confused when they read this text. They think that Jesus said that upon Peter. No! It is upon that revelation that Jesus will build his church on. Jesus cannot build, he cannot entrust his church on an ignorant heart. He wants a heart that really knows who he is. And that's when he says, I'll give you the keys. And when you have the keys into the kingdom, there is no door that is locked for you. At a time like this, personal revelation will keep you. What you know about Jesus is what will save you. What you don't know about Jesus is what is going to destroy you. Be blessed, be a blessed man. I'm just like to summarize and say what I simply say, that there are two sources of revelation. Revelation.
One, it is from man. Number two, it is from God. And it is this revelation, what God reveals to us, that's what makes us a blessed people. Not what we know by our own understanding. So, brethren, as we wind up this message, I know that you'll be blessed wherever you are. Strive, seek, ask who Christ is, and it is the pleasure of God to reveal himself to his people. Jesus did not want to walk with 12 men who do not know him. Even today, God will not walk with an ignorant heart. Make it your responsibility. Make it your priority to seek and to know God. May the Lord bless you so much. Be a blessed man. Shalom. Shalom. Amen.